give this ordinary chest an old rustic look. Let's see how I changed this to this. For the base color, I am mixing a gray chalk paint with the baking powder. You will be surprised how easy, cheap, and good medium the baking powder is in creating a texture. Any light chalk paint will do to start with. By stippling the paint in, turning the brush, I am creating even more texture and avoiding any brush strokes. To give the piece a bit more character, I applied a raised stencil using a plaster of Paris. Just one note here, the plaster must be creamy, neither running nor too thick, and you make small amounts as it dries quickly. You can keep adding tiny amount of water if you are doing a larger stencil, and then sand it lightly when it's dry. For the second cover, I wanted to create an earthy color, and I have mixed a few colors together. If you are interested, see the details in the description below. I mixed my paint with water, using a bit more water than the paint. With the wet rag, I am dabbing the paint wash off and spraying with water as I go. Next step is a black wash. I don't want an even coverage here. As you will see in the end, nothing should be even or symmetrical in this piece. As you noticed, I have also added a mold to the top drawer. I have made it using the mold and the epoxy resin. Here, I dip the brush into water and then into the paint. I am using a wet rag to blend the wash and my spray bottle with water to let the paint run down freely. But I am picking it with the wet rag, as I want more blended look. As you can see, I have done one side already, but the piece is not finished yet. I am applying the black wash and my base light wash simultaneously, creating the shades. And I will be going back and forth again and again to achieve the look I am aiming for. I am applying more black, lifting it up and spreading it around with my wet rag. Two rugs, one for the black wash and another for the light wash. It is an easy way to blend the paint. Just don't forget to step back every now and then to evaluate the result and to see where you're going with your design. Changing the rugs, going back and forth with the two paint washes, and spraying the surface with water all I am doing here is creating the lighter and the darker shades. To create a wholesome look on the piece, it is better to work when the drawers are in the place. But after each cover, I am taking the drawers out to paint around them. I am applying a stencil to each corner, and the colors I have chosen are honfleur, aubusson blue, black and white. I am applying them randomly with a sponge and then blending them together. When the stencils are dry, I am going over them with a steel wool to blend the colors together even more and to give the stencils a faded look. After all my previous paint is dry, my next step is aubusson blue paint wash, mixed half to half with water. Here, I am dabbing the wash with the kitchen paper, taking the excesses off and spreading the wash around. The dry paper absorbs more paint and creates more faded color. And spreading it around with the saturated paper, making it darker on the bottom, the edges and the crevices, and lighter to the middle and the top of the chest. Misting the surface with water is helping me to move the paint wash around and to blend it with the other colors. As you can see, all I am doing is spreading the paint around and blending the colors, trying to create more authentic, natural look. That is only half of the way to achieving the aged look. Keep watching. Again, after the last coat is dry, I am applying the same light mixture with this small wooden spatula. You can use a plastic spatula, but not the metal one, unless you want to expose the original wood. Now I am doing the same with the black paint. Next steps are to bring all the colors together and to make the chest looking like it wasn't painted over a few days, but been going through its life stages for years. Here I am doing a light paint wash. The same mixture of the paint mixed with water again, but not over the whole piece. Here I am more precise with what I am doing and where I am applying my colors. And here it is just water, which I used for the black wash. First is the honfleur paint wash. Sorry that the picture is too bright. I am not a very good cameraman. Still, I wanted to show you that I am creating some rust here and there. In the end, you will see it all blended together, as the piece is not as bright or light as it shows here. Few touches of aubusson blue. You can also see on your screen my working stages on the top of the chest. I am giving it a very old, worn out look, and I'll show you how I've done it. Keep watching! I want to add some brown wax, but the one I have from Liberon is too bright, almost reddish. I have added some of the black wax to it and got the darker wax I wanted. As always, I am covering the whole piece with the clear wax. The bottom I am covering with the black wax, taking the excesses off with a lint-free rug. There is a dark wax in Annie Sloan collection, but I don't have it, so I made my own. If you want to mix waxes, the best way is to heat them a bit in a microwave, just to make them softer, and it will be a lot easier to mix them. Makeover gilding wax. I like this one because it is dark and has almost a bronze shine to it. Someone asked me in the comments which brand it is. I got it on Amazon. It is antique gilding wax. After my waxes are dry, I have slightly sanded the whole piece and covered it again with a clear wax. For the top, I am adding some black chalk paint to my base color, which is gray. As you saw at the beginning, I have done two coats of the base color mixed with the baking powder to create the texture. Now I'm stippling in the paint. I haven't mixed the black and the gray properly, as I want to have the traces of the black and the gray to be seen. Later you will see why. Next step is a black paint wash. I am creating the spots of the different shades, which will be revealed in the end, when I will sand the top. When the paint is dry, I am spraying it with water and applying a dark wood stain, again with no particular pattern. Then spraying it with water and taking the excesses off with a wet rag, leaving some spots darker than the others. When the last coat is dry, I have made my light mixture again, and I am spreading it with a wooden spatula. As I said before, the plastic spatula would be even better, but not the metal one. As I said at the beginning, I have mixed 5 different colors to create a light, but your fiddle. It is difficult to make the second portion of exactly the same color, so if it is a bit darker, it is okay. I just don't want it to be too bright or too white. Then I took the black wash left over water and spread it over the top, creating the spots. Let it dry, sanded slightly, and covered with my light color wash with very little paint in it, almost water. When the top is dry, I am distressing it with a spatula, revealing the layers underneath. Here I am using a metal spatula. Just a tip, It is easy to distress when you just go over the surface with a moist rug. To achieve a good result, don't wet the surface too much and don't press the spatula too hard. To finish, I have applied a clear wax, then a brown wax. Here is the finished result. I hope you learned a thing or two, and I'll be happy to see your comments and answer your questions. And please, do not forget to subscribe if you haven't done it yet. Thank you for watching. Take care, and I'll see you with my next project.